The situation follows a surprising turn of events. The region experienced heavy rains in May this year that led to substantial destruction of crops, only to be followed by an extended dry spell.
It's true, climate change is real, and the risks are being, you know, experienced at the moment. For the past 3 months, it's not rained in Rwanda, I must admit, most probably in Pongo Parish.
This unprecedented event marks the first occurrence of such a prolonged drought in the history of Rwanda District and the broader Kigezi region. Farmers residing in the affected area expressed distress, noting that this unexpected drought differs significantly from the usual climatic patterns they are accustomed to. Typically, the region witnesses the onset of rains in August, a pattern that has not materialized this year.
All the swamps have been reclaimed, the trees have been cut. People really do not mind about, you know, the environmental protection and conservation. There is a lot of plastic pollution, the soils have been degraded.
The unfortunate consequence is the withering of seedlings that were optimistically planted, anticipating the arrival of the rains. Perplexed by the sudden shift in weather patterns, farmers are left pondering the factors responsible for the end of rainfall. They strongly urge the government to institute a program that can offer them access to seedlings, which is now a critical necessity.
We really have to up the game to ensure, you know, the environmental initiatives, protection and conservation, you know, adopted by everybody. Because minus that, then I think we are yet to see a lot of havoc.
Prosim Babazi Akampurira, the woman MP for Rwanda District, underscores that the drought issue extends beyond Rwanda, affecting the broader region. Akampurira acknowledges the sequential challenges posed by unusual weather patterns following the heavy rains that initially impacted the area. She pledges to educate farmers about adaptive farming practices that account for evolving climate conditions.
And we have experienced this after experiencing the heavy rains. You know, we are at a time where things are not easy. When we experienced the heavy rains that brought a lot of challenges, and now we are experiencing that drought, that too much sunshine, that is hot. I had not seen this in Rwanda before.
Evelyn Chikafunda, the founder of Green Environment Protection, a local NGO, laments the prolonged drought's toll on farmers in Rwanda and Kigezi region. She attributes the erratic climate patterns to environmental degradation, including deforestation, swamp reclamation, and plastic pollution. Chikafunda's concerns extend to people's lack of environmental consciousness. In her call to action, Chikafunda urges collective efforts to safeguard the environment and encourages environmentalists to devise effective strategies for preservation.
The environmental activists and champions, you know, have to come up and see how best we devise means to ensure everybody knows it's their responsibility to protect and conserve the environment.
As the situation persists, Rwanda District has not witnessed rainfall for 4 consecutive months, further worsening the concerns of farmers and community members. Report by Job Namanya for the news in Rwanda District.